Hello, 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 hello. Welcome to Echo Land. Yeah, anyway, it was echoing for me. It wasn't turned up for y'all, was it? That's cool. Anyway, welcome to today. It is Monday. It's been a pretty good Monday. Had me some brunch. Had me a good ride. And now I'm going to put together a Go service and containerize it. Somehow, some way or another. I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to do this. I'm just going to kind of start, and we're going to work through it. That's what I'm going to do. So for all 52,000 of you, this is how it's done. We just got to figure it out. I'm going to start with a repo because, you know, why would you not start with a repo, right? But before the repo priorities, as they are, there we go. All right, little tunes in the background. We'll get going here. Okay. Wantala, whatever that is. All right. I can't even drag the thing off the screen right. There we go. Okay, what should we call this? Containerizing Go? Go containerization. Containing Golang. A containerization example with Go. Sound good? Oh, that kind of sounds good, I think. Oh God. Stranger Things 3 Microsoft Windows 1.1.1 re-release today app thing. So that's what that thing. I was wondering about that earlier today on the Twitters. Like, what was that thing? Why was everybody talking about Windows 1.1.1? That was like the release nobody used. Nobody. I don't think Microsoft used it, but for a hot 10 minutes before 3.1.1 was released. But anyway, I digress. We're not here to talk about that. Let's continue. Okay, gotta get some, bear with me here, getting some stuff organized and put where it needs to be. All right. So we got a repo we can clone now. So let's do that. We're gonna clone that down to, so I've enabled modules too, by the way. So was it echo dollar go 1.1.1 modules? Oh, on. Okay, there we go. So modules are on. I'm gonna move into my code directory here. And we're going to make a dir. No, we're not. We're going to just straight git clone it. Like so. There we go. And then how is it that we start a go mod project? I think it's just go mod init. Actually, yeah, let's just go with that as the guess. CD containing Golan list. Go mod init, right? Hey, what a wild guess. Yep, okay, and then let's list all that. git ignore. Okay, let's hear about our git ignore. Let's open this up in code. Boom. There's our mod. Search marketplace. Yeah, let's look for this thing. Paradox syntax, data flex. No, that's not what we're looking for. Yep, don't need that. That's not what we're using. Go thing. Anyway, okay, forget that. So we got our git ignore though. We want to add, let's add the Mac stuff just in case somebody opens it on a Mac. And then let's add that stays in case we open it in GoLand, the JetBrains IDE, or any of the other ones. It'll block out that directory. Okay, they're at data store IDA. Just added that. And let's add a main.go. Make sure install. I do all the go stuff, please. Update. Get project names, get history. Let's install git lens to customize. How do I do that? Oh, I don't know if I wanted all that crap. Anyway, okay. That's gone. What the heck? Check. Just arbitrarily doing that? Whatever. There we go. Let's add. Right. Then funk main thing here. Let's see about going mux sample. Install. Da-da-da-da. I just want to walking routes. It's a working example. So all I need is an example to run with here. Yeah, that should work. Let's go with this one. Oops, let's do this. No need for two. Mains. Okay, and now let's do go build. Let's. Package main right before, right? Yep. Okay. Oh, there we go. I just didn't copy and paste it right. You know, it happens. So let's see here. We got retaining Golang. Oh, bananas. What did that just say? Oh, it walked all that. Ah, that isn't what I wanted. I know there's some better examples out there. Ah. Filling services, hello world example. Just want something that, yeah, there we go. Let's do this. Check that out, that's perfect. We don't need all that other stuff. Yeah. Whoa, what did I do? Containing. There we go. We should be listening, sir. Maybe it's not a good one. A little bit better. Well, here's one with Mux. It might be even, yeah, this is even better. What happened? Let's just do it first. Oops. First commit. Yeah, why is this? There's nothing else here that I see. Yeah, go build. The executable is containing Golang. Doesn't do shit. Let's try out my other app. Xbox services base. Config.json. Oh, IP right here. Ah, see, that's working. Actually, let's just take that one, right? And I even have a Docker file in it. Yes, please install the Docker extension. Okay. Ah, nice. Dependency list is growing appropriately here. That's, yeah, okay. Let's install CQL. Cool. Nothing for shell? I do already have that mark, that plugin added. Yeah, I guess so. Markdown. That's neat. Okay. Oh, and this is for the server side of things. So I kind of need a Docker Compose for all this to run on. Could get it to run on one container, maybe. Ah. Well, we'll deal with the other container in a minute. Right now, try to get the container here built. Fun. I wonder if I should even do that. Does that need to be there? Doesn't really need to be. Even though this is used to build the app, if it goes out on a container, it really just needs to have the executable. February, December 18. What does this say, dude? Okay, so make dir. Oh, I don't need to do that. Okay, I don't need a test app. I don't need to do that. Nope, don't need to do that stuff. Just did that. So this project, the truck service base, that app is module based now, and it should be all set. Let's see your get status. Yeah, clear. Alright, let's see. From Golang 11. Let's do it to that one. Alpine 310 should be okay though, I would think. I mean, it technically doesn't even need go on it. That's just for like building the crap. Let's add a label. Double quotes, yeah. Huh. That was cool. Markup and everything. So then set the current working directory inside the container. So working dir. That, but it doesn't need to be that in here. So it says get label and then work dir here, and we're actually going to call this, let's call this service. Yeah. Oh wait, but wait, is that? Oh yeah, work dir. That would be services base. Is that what I called it? Yes. What's it saying? What's it saying? It should be an absolute Docker file, you think? Path should be absolute. Oh, okay. I guess I should do. Even though I'm using modules. Oh, can I just do this? No, of course not. Oh, I can do that. Okay. Let's try that, and then copy dot to dot, run. Now what's this? What do the three dots mean? Download all of the, okay, I don't have to worry about that, I don't think. Well, what does that actually mean? Go look at it. Okay. So I guess I can just take this as is. Do that, I think. This is going to be 8079. Run the executable go docker. Oh, is that the name of the, yeah, go docker. So the executable is not go docker, but trucks services base. Fetching going. Does that need to be on first? Oh, oops. Alright, so we got executable file not found a path, git. So I guess it needs frickin' git installed. Let's do this after all. Let's see if I can take that out and git. Actually, I'll leave this, comment it, and then let's run it. Oh, it's supposed to be this. Oh, this is okay. Okay. Damn. Return to non-zero code. I guess then let's try run, go build. Eh? I guess the other question, though, is does this thing run? We just tested it. It ran. And return to one still. So if I do go build. Ah. Address already in use. Is that running? Oh, this one's running. Okay, exit. Okay. So that works. So if I just go build, it's there. Pretty obvious there. So let's... Try that one. Docker build. Docker build dash T trucks services base thing. I mean, that's basically what I'm doing. It's just it's gonna do that, then it'll break. Let's not do this, and let's not do this. Let's try this. Hey, did that just work? What did he say for the run command? Multi-sage? Oh, interesting. What's this? This is, oh, he's building it just to start from the building. This is a container. There we go. Okay, so Docker run. There we go. That'll work. So Docker run p, and then we'll map 8079 to 8079 trucks services base. Boom. There we go. This is looking promising. Alright, so then if we curl localhost 8079. No, curl. Do we have to do this? So he did that. 10. That ran it. We're running here. Why is it not exposing it? Oh, let's do that. Oh, conquer, stop, eager foes. Docker, run, oops, start, eager bows. A-G-E-R, bows. Ah, there we go. Start it right back up. Log file, app log. Trucks, space. I can't run trucks, service, base, right? No, okay. Yeah, let's do this real quick. And so I got all that added, but let's change this to trucks, services, base, triple D log, app name, log, logger, app log. And that broke it. Craigslist as a directory. I like this blog entry though. This is good because it's building dark containers for go. Well, let's go with this mess. Just do it from scratch with. Actually, let's do this. Let's do Golang modules container. Let's just, yeah. Gerp. Let's just do this, and then we'll call it. I don't know. Let's hear. Maker. Okay. HTTP server. This is pissing me off. Cannot determine module path for source directory. How did I just do this other one? See, I called it containing Golang. Today is not my day. Golang desktop app. That's not what.
Hi, Gophers. My name is Alex Pluto, and welcome to Package My.
Hi, Alex. Let's just do all this, just like he says here. Yeah, it still doesn't frickin' work. All right, well, let's go back up even more on this shit. I don't want to create a module. It's not even... Make dir. Hello. What? Oh, is that because... Okay, I think this is starting to make sense. Because what you need for the module to work is you need it. This is. I'm not sure. This is clearly a situation where you have to be connected. It's turning into a situation where you have to be connected to the internet. You can't do this without the internet. And that kind of sucks. For a whole multitude of reasons, but I guess we're always connected to the internet now, so whatever. It's one of the reasons I wanted modules to do this, where you we'll figure out, see if it works or not. All right, so let's do info. All right, let's just do this. Paste it in. Boom. That's one way to put it in a file. So that's catting the contents there. Cat into file, end on end of line, end of file, EOF. So that's the content. Then EOF at the end makes it kill and close the file. So now if I list, I got a hello.go and go.mod. So I can do a go build. And then hello, hello world. Okay. Right, cat. Yep. Go mod. Okay. So let's do this. Move hello. Move. There we go. Okay, so then now let's make her containing Galang. There we go. Oh, let's get rid of that one. Oh, that worked before because it was already mapped. It was cloned from a Git repo. So I guess when it did go mod init, it knew that it already had a reference to the github.com/whatever. So that's super annoying because like that one example we were just looking at wouldn't work. You have to know and assume that everything's attached to a damn repo. Okay, whatever. How many people actually know that? I mean, how you didn't the docs around that were pretty bad. Maybe it says it somewhere, but it doesn't say like, here's the three requirements. One of them is have it clone from a repo or have a repo attached to it in some way, form, or manner. So if I go up here, though, yeah, and then use go mod init and the repo. Let's do that. Let's say, and then we'll sync it with what we actually have up there. So let's do that. GitHub.com. Where did it go? I just created this like an hour ago. Oh, there it is. Okay. Yeah, so this has all our bits, right? Main.go. So let's do this. Git clone this thing. Git stream hacking. Right. So if we have that. Wait. So we have a build, but we shouldn't run it on the build server. We should run it on the multi build. Song is called Fat Man in a Pool. That is a weird thing to name a song, but whatever. Yeah, so see, it's already got that. And then let's clear it, go build. So we have containing Golang. It just runs through. It has no freaking pause. Why is that? What is... Do I have to put this in a log? Why wouldn't that listen and serve? Router, handle funk, this thing. Let's do this. Let's do code. Same stupid thing. It should work. Let's see here. Okay. And HTML. Hell. No. Just. Oh yeah. Let's do this. That one should work. I love monkeys. Thank you. Oh, is it waiting now? Are you kidding me? That's the old. Oh, I see. That's... Oh, I didn't save the file yet. Derp. Something about... Let's just do this. Your server is running. Yeah? Extra string. Oh. Hey, Cuskman, how are you? Fighting through this one today. Working on just container, well, doing a containerized build, and then I'm trying to get the executable to deploy into a container that's not the one that just built it, right? So that it's completely clean, just has the executable, no library or anything. Yeah, procrastination is a pain. Drives me nuts. Okay, we have that example. That, oh, I didn't post it up there. And then if we get our build going here, let's add a Docker file. And then in the Docker file, I'm gonna say using. No, that's not it. What was that other one? What happened? up in there from going. Right. Yeah, I had most of it written for this one, though, so I'm just going to steal this real quick. And go put it in here. There we go. Okay, so going 111. And truck service. Well, I don't need this, technically. So the only thing here, though, and maybe you have an answer for this. So, like, here I go, build. And, okay, so we know... Oops, I gotta fix this. This should be containing Golang. What did it say? Oh, right, okay. So containing Golang, expose that port. Right, working directory copy. Docker, ht, build. Do I even need a dash t? I don't remember. Anyway. Let's see here. What do we get? Oh, yeah. That's the one dependency. All right. So that built it. So the container should have the thing. And at this point, I have to cut it a bit short because I need to run some minor emergency errands here. But, we'll do a raid real quick. The question is, as always, who's out there doing stuff? Oh, Gypso. Maybe I'll raid Gypso again. Or no, let's raid Biscardi. Yeah. You want to raid Gypso? We'll raid Gypso again if you want to. Oh, Mr. Greggles is playing too. This dude's amazing. Oh, he's just playing a game right now. Definitely suggest go check out his when he plays his drums. Freaking amazing. Cool. All right, let's see here. Let me find. All right, getting the raid going here. So as always, get prepared, join in, and we will raid Jitspo in about 50 seconds here.